Thomson then, what is typecasting Thomson then?
Converting a data type to another data type.
What is the alternate name for typecasting, Amal? Alternate name for typecasting. Another name for typecasting. Rahul? What, Rahul? Which one? It's not clear, Rahul.
Explicit.
No. Another name for typecasting. Tushar?
Data type conversion.
Yes, data type conversion. Okay. Typecasting, the alternate name it is data type conversion. Data type conversion is also known as typecasting. Which are the two types of typecasting, Kevin? Kevin? Alan Joshi?
Ma'am.
Which are the two types of typecasting?
Explicit.
What?
Explicit.
Explicit.
Okay.
Explicit conversion and second one?
Ma'am, you didn't taught the second one.
Okay. So I will just explain the name. I think so. It is explicit and implicit conversion. Okay. Then Kevin, okay, Nestle, what is explicit conversion? Nestle? Okay. Abhilash, what is explicit conversion?
Now to change the data type with the help of the user.
With the help of the user. Then, which data type is used to, how we can convert integer value to float, Alan Thomas? Alan Thomas, how we can convert integer value into float? Using explicit conversion. Kevin, am I audible, Kevin? Sanjana.
Ma'am, is it by using int function?
Using which function? It is int function. To convert float into integer, we are using a special function, it is int. Okay, int is the function used to convert float value to any value to integer. Any value, either it is float, string, or bool value, we can convert that value into integer using the function int. Okay, Thomson then, Sarah, how we can convert a character, integer into character? Sarah?
Yes, ma'am.
Which function is used to convert integer into character?
Integer into character. Ma'am. Ma'am, yesterday I only joined late, right?
Okay. Iron? Iron? Okay, Rahul?
ASCII.
Which one?
ASCII.
That is ASCII value, no? Which function is used to convert integer into character? It is CHR. Okay. CHR is the function. So in the case of explicit conversion, the conversion done by the user, that is explicit conversion, that is conversion done by one external person, that is explicit, by external user, that is explicit conversion. Okay, Sanam, Iron, Sara, Kevin, all of you switch on the video.
One second, ma'am. Some connection is auto on now.
Okay. So, explicit conversion is the conversion done by the user. There is one external person. That is explicit conversion. Forcefully convert one data type into another data type with the help of user. That is explicit conversion. Then, in explicit conversion, we are using mainly four functions. Which are the four functions, Kevin? Which are the four functions used in explicit conversion, Kevin?
Ma'am, can you repeat the question, ma'am? I didn't. My connection went.
Okay, in under explicit conversion, we are using some built-in functions. Which are the built-in functions used in explicit conversion? For converting float into integer, we are using one function. For converting some value to float, we are using another function. For converting character, we are using another function, just like that.
Ma'am, CHR, int, float.
Then one more is there. Correct, Kevin. So under explicit conversion, we are using four built-in functions. First one, it is int. Int is used to convert value to integer, any value to integer, whole number. Okay. Then second one, it is float. Float is used to convert a value to float number. What is float number, Sanam?
A number with decimal point
is known as float value. So if you want to convert a value to float, we will use the function float within bracket write that value, or within bracket write the statement to input the content. Okay, then str is used for converting a value into string. What is string, Sara? What is string? How we can represent a string?
A set of character in double quote or single quote.
A set of characters within single quotes or double quotes is known as string. So if you want to convert a value to string, we are using the built-in function str. Then if you want to convert a number into character, we are using another built-in function, it is chr. Okay. Then what is ASCII? Anish Salian, switch on the video. Anish, what is ASCII? What is the full form of ASCII? Sayujya? Abraham, Sayujya, Alan Thomas, Irene, Anish, all of you switch on the video. Sayujya, switch on the video. Iron. Anish, what is ASCII, Anish?
Ma'am?
What is ASCII?
We use the function for character.
ASCII is a function.
That we have to use in character. A is equal to.
So converting ASCII means it is American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Okay. American Standard Code for Information Interchange. That is ASCII. That is each and every character in our keyboard has its own ASCII value. What is the value of capital letter A, Tushar?
125.
Capital letter A. It is 65. Then what about a small letter I have lash?
97.
Yes. Then Abhijit, what is small letter Z? Abhijit?
Ma'am, I just came.
Okay, what is the ASCII value of 120? Okay, what is the ASCII value of capital letter Z? Abhijit, what is the ASCII value of capital letter Z?
I'm not sure.
You just tell.
Ma'am, numerical value?
Which value? Which numerical value?
I'm not sure, ma'am.
Okay, Abhiram?
Ma'am, is it 97?
Yes, 97. Okay. So, ASCII values means the American standard code for information interchange. That means integer value that represents the integer values for each and every characters in the keyboard. Okay. All the alphabets, all the digits and almost all the white spaces we have, it's on ASCII value. Okay. So, that is explicit conversion. For explicit conversion, we are using four functions. The first one, it is int. Second one, it is float. Third one, it is str. Then fourth one, it is chr. Chr is used for converting into character. Str is used for converting a value into string. Float is used to convert a particular value into float. And int is for converting a value to integer. Okay. Then second one, it is implicit conversion. Write the heading implicit conversion. It is just opposite to explicit conversion. That is, implicit conversion is the conversion done without the help of a user. That is the conversion done by the interpreter. The system interpreter is converting. Automatic conversion is implicit conversion. Implicit conversion is the conversion done without the help of user, or it is the automatic type conversion. Implicit conversion is also known as automatic type conversion. The interpreter automatically convert one data type to another data type. Abhijit, switch on the video. Basuri, switch on the video. All of you, switch on the video. Okay. So, implicit conversion, it is also known as automatic conversion. That is a conversion done without the help of a user. It is implicit conversion. That is, the conversion is by the interpreter, Python interpreter. Okay. So, I'll give one example. If I'm assigning a value A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 5.5. C is equal to 10 plus 5.5. That is, A plus B. This is one of my Python program. That is, what is the meaning of first statement, Irene? What is the meaning of this first statement? Try, Irene. No problem. Okay.
Ma'am,
no problem. Okay. I will explain. Yeah. Anyone? Okay. What are in?
Okay. The statement hasn't been
included. Without input, I am just writing one statement. A is equal to 10. This is the assignment operator. Then what is the meaning? Anyone?
A is assigned to 10 is assigned to A.
Correct, Sarah. 10 is assigned to A. That is the meaning of the first statement. A is equal to 10 means equal to means assignment operator. We already discussed that it's the operator that is equal to this assignment operator. The meaning of the statement is that 10 is assigned to A. So after executing this statement, the value of A is 10. Okay. Then what is the meaning of this statement, second statement, Alan Thomas? Alan Thomas?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the meaning of second statement? So turn the video.
5.5 is assigned to B.
Okay. I want to see your face. So turn the video.
Ma'am, I have some network issues.
Okay. So B is equal to 5.5 means this 5.5 is assigned to B. Okay. This is 10 is integer value. 5.5 is a float value. Okay, here I am using a statement like C is equal to A plus B. What will happen here? Here, the value of A, it is 10, and the value of B, it is 5.5. Okay, so the interpreter automatically convert this 10 into float. That is implicit conversion. Okay. Inside the execution, that is 10.0. 10 is converted to 10.0 plus 5.5. So the result, it is 15.5. Okay. So the system automatically convert integer value into float because integer value needs less space than float value. So the higher value data type, the lower value data type is converted to higher value data type. Okay, that is implicit conversion. Here I am using integer value and here I am using float value. When we consider these two data types, float is the biggest data type. So the system automatically convert this integer data type into float data type. So this 10 is converted to 10.0. Okay. So after converting this 10 integer value into float value, that is 10.0, it will add these two values. That is 10.0 plus 5.0. The result is 15.5. This is automatic conversion or implicit conversion. The system, if one expression includes two types of values, here, C is equal to A plus B means the type of A, it is integer. And the type of B, it is float. If one expression includes values with different data type, the system automatically convert one data type to another data type based on its size. The lowest data type is converted to highest data type by the system itself. There is no need of user help. The system automatically convert lowest data type into highest data type. That type of conversion is known as implicit conversion. If you are using small letter A, capital letter A and one integer value, the system automatically convert this small capital letter A into integer. What is the integer value of capital letter A?
65.
Okay. So 65 plus 50. So if there is one expression that is with value with different data type values, here I am using integer value and float value. So before the addition operation, the integer value is converted to float value. The conversion is based on the size of the data type. Integer data type is smaller than float data type. The order it is, first it is character, then integer, then float, then string. Okay, so if char and int is there, in one expression, char and int is there, The Python interpreter automatically convert this character into integer. Okay. Then perform the operation. Then in the case of integer and float, what will happen? Abhijit, what is 5 plus 5 plus 1? Which data type is converted to which one? Abhijit, okay.
Can you repeat?
In that 5 plus 5.1, which implicit conversion has happened?
Implicit.
How?
Implicit conversion.
Implicit conversion. How? This 5 is converted to 5.0. Okay. Here we are using
5.10.
0.0.
Yes, ma'am.
5 is equal to 5.0. Okay. 5 is integer value. 5.1 is float value. So here the biggest data type it is float. So the last data type is converted to biggest data type. That is int is converted to float. Okay. That conversion is done by the system or Python interpreter without the user help. So that type of conversion is known as implicit conversion. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So the this is the implicit conversion, the conversion done without the help of user, or it is the automatic type conversion. The system automatically convert one data type to another data type based on its size. Okay, char is converted to int, int is converted to float. If I have a value that is a and 9.2, this char is converted to float, that is the value, integer value is 6, that is converted to 65.0 plus 9.2. This conversion 8 to 65.0, that conversion is automatically happened by the Python interpreter. So that type of conversion is known as implicit conversion. Is it clear? Okay. So there are mainly two types of conversion. Data type conversion means, all of you switch on the video. Data type conversion means conversion from one data type to another data type, that is data type conversion. Then in the case of data type conversion, the alternate name it is, which one is the alternate name, Amal? Data type conversion alternate name? It is type casting. Okay, Amal? Type casting. Okay, so data type conversion is also known as type casting. There are mainly two types of data type conversion. First one is explicit conversion, that is conversion done with the help of user. For that, we are using some built-in functions. Int, float, chr and str are the functions used in explicit conversion. The second one, it is implicit conversion. What is implicit conversion, Rahul?
Conversion
will be
done without the help of user.
Correct, Rahul. That is the conversion done by the system or without the help of user. That is implicit conversion. It automatically converts one data type to another data type. That is from lower size data type to bigger one. Okay, that is implicit conversion. These are the different two conversion methods. Okay, now we will start with a simple program. Write the question. Write a program to multiply two numbers. Multiply two integer numbers. So we are starting off Python program. First program it is. Addition we already done, I think so. Add two numbers.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So multiplication, multiply two integer numbers. How we can write the program? Basuri. How we can write the first statement, Basuri? Okay, Anjana.
Like A into B, so 67 into 65 into 9.
No. First, my question is to multiply two numbers. That is, A into B is the operation. But before doing this operation, we want to input some values to A and B. Then only we can multiply. Okay. First, we want to input some value to A and B. Then only we can perform this operation. Okay. Then how we can input? Okay. How we can input one value to A? What, Anjana?
97.
This is the variable name, Anjana.
98.
A and B are the variable names. It's not a character, it is variable name. So I will explain. Just listen. So my question is to write a program to perform different write a program to perform multiplication using two integer values. Okay, that is the question. So that is, I want to multiply 3 into 2 or 4 into 2, just like that. Two integer values multiplication, that is the program. For that, first I want to input first value, that is 3. Okay, first I want to input first value. How we can input one integer value to a variable? Thompson, then?
Input statement.
Yes, using input statement. Okay, how we can write A is equal to int input and the first number. Okay, that is the first statement. For multiplying two numbers, first I want to input one value. Okay. So for inputting first integer value, I want to write the statement like this: A is equal to int input n the first number. Sanam, how we can input the second number?
A B I N D.
B is equal to
I N D bracket.
That is int. Okay. You pronounce this just like int. It's not INT, int. Okay. Int within bracket.
Enter.
Input. Enter.
Input second.
Okay. Correct, Sanam. A is equal to int within bracket input enter first number. B is equal to int input enter second number. Okay, so when we execute the first statement, the value is, if I'm inputting one value from keyboard 5, that value is converted to integer and that integer is stored in 5, in A. So the content of 8 is 5. Is it clear, Amal? Okay, by heart this statement, that is A is equal to int input enter first number is for inputting one value from user or from keyboard. If you want to input one integer value, you want to use the statement int input enter first number. Okay. All of you switch on the video. Then what about the second statement? Enter second number. So I am inputting another value, this 10. Then this 10 is stored into B. 5 is stored into A. So we get two values for this multiplication operation. Then what is the next one? Next thing, we want to perform that operation. M is equal to A into B. M is the variable used to store the result. Okay, M is equal to A into B. That means content of A it is 5, then content of B it is 10. So 5 into 10 is calculated. The result 50 is stored in M. Okay, so using int input statement, I enter one integer value and it is stored in A. Okay, after that, using the second statement, I am inputting another integer value and it is stored in B. Next, I want to perform the particular operation. Here, I want to perform multiplication operation. Okay, multiplication operation. So for that, I will write M is equal to A into B. A into B, the result is assigned to M, that is 15. Is it clear? Then how I print this value? You say print statement, print M. So the content of M is displayed. The content of M is 50. 50 is displayed. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt? Anyone? Then write a program to subtract two numbers. Write a program to subtract two numbers. Completed, Anjana? Okay. Basuri, read the first statement, Basuri. Basuri. Okay, Irene, read the first statement. Alan Varghese, read the first statement, Alan Varghese. Why you are not responding? If you don't know, you just say, I don't know. Alan Varghese. You just joined the meeting and doing something, some other works. Abhijit, read the first statement. We are starting Python programming. It is very important topics, okay? Abhijit?
Ma'am.
Okay. Read the first statement for subtraction.
Where, ma'am? Reading.
First statement for the program.
Ma'am, is it in the book?
No. Why are you asking like this? Abhijit, I am saying the question. That the question is, write a program to calculate, perform subtraction operation between two integers. That is the question. Just like multiplication operation, perform subtract operation. Subtraction between two integers. That is the question. Is it clear, Abhijit?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then Thompson, read the first statement.
A equal to input, enter the first number.
Okay. Alan, read the second and third statement.
B equal to input, enter second number.
Okay. Then?
To A minus B. Print M.
Okay. So, the statement is? A is equal to int input, enter first number. B is equal to int input, enter second number. Then after entering two values, we want to perform the operation. Here the operation, it is subtraction. For subtraction, the result is stored in M. We can give any name here. We can give S here, SUB here, any name you can give here. Okay, I'm giving SUB. For storing the subtraction result, I'm giving SUB. Then after that, A minus B. Then how I print the statement? Print SUB. Okay, so first I input one integer value. For example, I'm entering 10. So content of 8 is 10. After that, I input another value, it is 8. So the content of B, it is 8. What will happen here? Here, substitute this A with the content of A. What is the value of A, Kevin?
My value is 10.
10. What is the value of B, Kevin?
8.
8. So, the content of A, it is 10. Content of B, it is 8. So, 10 minus 8. The answer, it is 2. Then, print sub means the content of sub is printed. What is the content of sub, Amal? What is the content of sub?
8.
No, it is 2. 10 minus 8, 2 is stored in sub. So, content of sub, it is 2. So, content of sub, it is 2. So, in the output screen, it will print like this, 2. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. Then another question. Write a program to find the cube of a number. Find the cube of a number. Cube of a number. Abraham, read the first statement, Abraham.
Sorry, ma'am?
Read the first statement.
A equal to input. Input enter. Enter number.
Enter number. Int input. Okay. A is equal to int input, enter one number. Because we need only one number. For finding cube, we need only one number. What's the meaning of cube? That is A into A into A. That is cube. Okay. So that is for inputting, we need, for finding the cube, we need only one number. So A is equal to int input and one number. Abhijit, what is the next statement, Abhijit? Abhijit? What is the next statement?
Ma'am, I'm getting confusion, ma'am.
Why?
So many things.
What?
Ma'am, so many things getting confusion. Ma'am, is it AX?
No. How we can find addition of two numbers? How is the, how we can perform addition in a Python program, Abhijit?
Ma'am, A. That's star.
That's star is for multiplication. Addition, we are using plus.
A plus.
Okay.
A plus A.
A plus B. That is addition. Just like that, you want to write the statement like this, okay? That is, first you want to enter one number, that is int input, enter one number. Then, after that, you want to find out there is nothing to input, only one number is needed for the calculation. So I input one value and it is stored in A, and I want to store the result. R is equal to, how we can find out the cube? In maths, we are finding cube just like this, A raised to 3. But we can't write this statement here in Python. A raised to 3, we can write like this, that is A into A. This is the equation for finding the cube. A into A. We cannot write like this. A raised to 3.
Ma'am, we can do A star star 3, right?
A star star 3 is also correct. Okay. So, R is equal to A into A. Or we can write R is equal to A exponent 3. One more function is there, that is power. We discussed that function for finding this cube or finding the power. We are using another built-in function, this power. So three options are there. Two, we already learned these two options. This we will discuss in the next chapter. Okay. So R is equal to, so after inputting one number into A, we want to find out the cube. For finding the cube, the equation is R is equal to A into A into A. Or we can write R is equal to A exponent 3. After that, we want to print the result. How we can print the result? Print R. Is it clear, Abhijit? Abhijit?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, for finding the cube of a number, first you want to input one value or one integer value to variable A. After that, you want to perform that operation. For that, you want to write the mathematical equation in Python. For finding cube, the mathematical equation, it is A raised to 3. We want to convert that equation into Python format. That is A into A into A, or we can write A exponent 3. Okay. So, any of this statement you can give like this. R is equal to A into A into A, or R is equal to A exponent 3. After that, so after executing this statement, A, if the value of A is 2, 2 into 2 into 2, 8 is the result, that 8 is assigned to R. Print R means 8 is displayed. Okay. Is it clear? Abhira?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Alan Thomas? Okay, absent. Alan Varghese?
Yes, ma'am.
Anish?
Present, ma'am.
Abarna absent. Krishnanunya absent. Nestle absent. Rahul absent. Sayuja present. Vishnu.
Present, ma'am.
Vishnu.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Rahul is present. Okay. Naveen absent. Then Alan Joshi present, Anjana present, Buddhadev absent, Iron present, Sahan absent, Sara present, Tom Sinden present, Tushar absent. Then Abhiram
present.
Abhiram is present. Abhijit, Abhiram, Abhilash is present. Amal present, Basudi, Kevin, Omar absent, Sanam, Sanjana. Okay. So Abhijit, where is your name? No, first time in my class, Abhijit?
No, not first time.
Okay.
There from the start.
Okay, in which division, Abhijit?
C section.
C.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. We'll continue in the next class. Okay.